Suzanne Vance from the city of Harrisonburg, and I think perhaps this will get at the other gentleman's question that wasn't answered the last for the last panel. This is directed to Mr. Hutcheson. You announced your run for sheriff 3 months after accepting the police department chief job in Woodstock. Why should I or we think that you're going to serve all 4 years and not run for another political opportunity should it arise? Thank you.
And first off, that's factually incorrect. I announced my run a year later. I was hired as the chief of police in Woodstock in January of 2010. I made my formal announcement to run for sheriff of Rockingham County in the city of Harrisonburg on January the 25th of 2011. A little over a year later, and quite frankly, I've had two jobs in my whole life, I guess. I stated before, high school, college, state police for 16 years, up into my current position, which has now been a little over a year and a half as chief of police for Woodstock. Now, with Woodstock, I'm not in a contract with them. I told them that I had no intentions of moving there, and they were fine with that. We had no verbal or written agreement for the term of my time there. So that was a simple matter of, in January of 2010, I was hired. As you recall, it was late, maybe say November of 2010, that the sheriff here in Rockingham announced that he was not going to seek re-election. So it was 11 months later that the announcement came out. I talked about it with some of the supporters of mine that are in this room, the law enforcement folks you see on that list that know me, that have worked with me. And I spent those 2 months talking to those people and saying, is this something I should pursue? What do we think about this? And what it came down to is, this is where we live. This is where we're raising our children. I believe in my qualifications to do it. I've never done anything other than law enforcement. I've never been a candidate for anything in my life. So there's no indications or there's no reason for any voter to believe otherwise.
30 seconds.
Thank you.
In the hypothetical world where Bryan is elected sheriff, don't worry, he's not leaving. This job has a lot of power, way too much power, pays way too much. Who would leave this job? Nobody. That's why sheriffs become stagnant. That's why they're there forever. Once they get elected, they're not going anywhere. I recommend, it's part of one of the things I want to do, if you really are a true conservative, just try to put yourself out of a job if you're a government official. You truly are a conservative. I want to put myself out of a job. I don't think this is how we need to be.
30 seconds.
If I have three options on the table that I'd like to talk to the General Assembly about, the public safety subcommittees, one of which is term limits. I don't know why we have a term limit for the governor. One term, president, two terms. Sheriff can run forever, and you see what happens. If we have more time, I can give you a whole list of sheriffs throughout this state who've done nothing but bad stuff, and they're the only ones that got caught. Thank you.
I can promise you that I'm not going anywhere. I chose this community to perform law enforcement in 24 years ago. Unlike either one of my opponents, I've been in law enforcement longer than they've been in law enforcement. I've been there at the sheriff's office actually doing the job longer than they've been police officers.
My name is Joanna Abbott. I'm from Mount Crawford. And this has definitely been covered before, but I don't think it can be said enough. And my question is directed to CM. How exactly is your experience with local law enforcement so important to your future as the sheriff?
Once again, I think that it's been answered before, but we'll take another stab at it. Once again, the community, being born and raised here, I know the area. I know the people, and I think that that's extremely important for the area that you're going to serve law enforcement. Is that what your question is? Thank you.
Been here for a long time also. I'm sorry, did you ask if it was important to have a familiarity with local law enforcement or just the local?
How your local law enforcement.
Okay, gotcha. I've been here a long time also, by choice, not by birth. I couldn't choose that one. But I can tell you this, and I hate to keep going back to, let me go this way. I've worked all four corners of this county. And prior to becoming a cop, I had never been to some of the hotspots. Did a great job there, solved a lot of cases. when you go into an area, you learn how to get out and talk to the people as a patrol deputy. They're a good source of information. I feel like pretty much everybody on the stage has been around. They know the area, they know the folks.
Okay, and what I would say to that is that I am the only candidate on the stage who has not worked for the Rockingham County Sheriff's Office. Okay, and I actually think that's an asset. I think that gives me the fresh perspective to look at the way they're operating, the way things are going on within that department, and see what can be improved upon, what can be done differently, what ways can we serve the public better. I have 17 years of law enforcement experience at all levels, patrol, investigations, and supervision, and I have done that all across the state of Virginia, in Richmond, Wytheville, you name it, you name a place, and I've probably been sent on an assignment there, and I can bring those experiences in those three aspects, patrol, investigations, and supervision, to the benefit of our sheriff's office right here, and the folks that believe the same are listed right here, many of whom work for the sheriff's office and have
faith
that my fresh perspective is exactly what we need at this time. Thank you.